In the 1980s, there were a lot of classic movies that came out that still stand the test of time today. These movies have been put onto DVD and Blu-ray, have a ton of bonus features on them, and plenty of commentary. Also, not only are these movies revered by many people, but they're discussed at length by fans and critics alike. There was another movie, however, that came out in the same decade that deserves all the same recognition, if not more. That movie is Rad. Over 25 years have passed since this movie's release, and it has still never come out officially on DVD or Blu-ray. And there's no news of whether this film ever will. Rad is about a BMX rider named Crew Jones who wants to race in Helltrack, a professional BMX race that is being built in his town. The problem is, he can't race in it. Throughout the movie, he defies the odds and is finally able to race in it. Meanwhile, the villain of the story, Duke Best, tries to get him disqualified at every turn so his company's BMX rider, Bart Taylor, will have less competition. Now, I know this sounds like a simple plot, but this movie has so much more going for it than it appears on the surface. First of all, this movie was directed by Hal Needham, who wasn't necessarily an experienced director, but was a highly experienced stunt coordinator of his day. Having worked on many movies with car chases and many action scenes, he was able to transfer his knowledge of stunt effects to this film. Due to this, we are treated to many stylish scenes throughout the entire film. This movie also has an experienced cast of actors who you would be surprised to see in a campy BMX movie. First we have Talia Shire, who co-produced this film, and next we have seasoned actors such as Ray Walston and Jack Weston, who plays the movie's antagonist. There's a certain scene in this movie which shows the true talent of Weston when he's talking to Crew. He probably flubbed the last line, but he saved the scene by pretending like he was at a loss for words.
Hi, I'm Crew Jones.
Just the person I've been looking for. Come on in.
Where are you? How would you like to be the man responsible for bringing BMX to all the small towns in the USA?
You don't understand. It's a chance of a lifetime. Don't be an idiot, kid. Think it over.
I don't have to. You and me, we don't think the same. Not at all.
Right there, 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 there. You'll regret it, I'm telling you. You'll live.
I'm glad the director kept this scene in the movie because it shows a great example of Weston's excellent ability to adapt to his role. Also, we have Lori Loughlin as our main character's love interest, who wasn't really that famous at the time, but was a great supporting character nonetheless. I like how the script had her as another BMX racer instead of just some piece of ass that the main character fancied, like every other girlfriend and character in a lot of movies. The most important reason why this film should be watched, however, is the pure 80s cheesiness of it. It uses slow-mo like it's going out of style, which it was. There was awesome 80s montages with cheesy music, and there's lame dialogue throughout. These factors were found in many awesome films from the 80s, and I think it's what's lacking from a lot of movies today. A lot of directors these days try to be serious with everything they do, and they forget that movies are supposed to be entertaining and fun. Well, that's all for my review. Be sure to sign the petition to get Rad finally put on DVD by clicking the link below. Thanks for watching, and have a great night.
Oh, here he is!
There's my Rad dude!
Hi, how you doing, buddy? How about some applause for our Rad dude?
That's fine.
Thank you. Thank you. Oh, no.